Dear students, now let us consider the energy of an orbiting satellite. See, this is, suppose this is an Earth and this is Earth satellite, and it is at a height of h from Earth surface, and its orbital speed is v0. Now it will possess potential energy as well as kinetic energy. So let us write expression for its kinetic energy. Its mass is small m, and mass of Earth is me. Now half m v naught square, but v naught means orbital speed. We already derived expression for orbital speed, and that was under root gm by r, where r is radius of the orbit, and it is sum of Earth radius plus height. Then v0 becomes g me by re plus h under root, or v naught square is equal to g me by re plus h. Substituting this value in kinetic energy expression, we get half m into g capital me by re plus h. Rearranging the terms, you can write by 2 into, or you can write 1 by 2 here, 1 by 2 re plus h. Now let us calculate potential energy. We already derived expression for gravitational potential energy, and that is minus g mass of Earth and mass of satellite divided by the distance between the two, that is minus g capital M small m by Earth radius plus height. Now you compare kinetic energy with potential energy. If you consider magnitude, the value of kinetic energy is half of the potential energy. And another thing, kinetic energy is positive whereas potential energy is negative. Now let us find total energy. So here 1 by 2 minus 1, taking the common. We get minus 1 by 2 g me m by re plus h. The strange thing is total energy also negative. What the negative sign suggests? Let me write here. Total energy is negative. What if total energy is zero or positive? If total energy is zero or positive, then the satellite will not be bounded by Earth. It will not revolve around Earth. Then it just escapes into space to infinity. Now let us look at solid example 9.8. A 400 kg satellite is in a circular orbit of radius 2 re about the Earth. So mass is given, mass of the satellite, and radius of the orbit is given. How much energy is required? First one, how much energy is required to transfer it to a circular orbit of radius 4 re? That is double the radius. So now that also let me write here, r2 is equal to 4 re. It means double the r1. Now how much energy is required to transfer it to a circular orbit of radius 4 re? So first let me write expressions for potential energy. Minus g me small m by re plus h. Similarly, expression for kinetic energy, it is half of this but positive. Now let me write expression for total energy. Minus 1 by 2 MEM by RE plus H. Now this is our Earth, around Earth. This is radius R1. Now you want to transfer the satellite into higher orbit of radius R2. For that some energy is required. So total, and what is the total energy of first orbit? Let us see. Total energy of first orbit, that is minus 1 by 2 G capital ME small m by, see, RE plus H means it is orbit radius R1. Now total energy of higher orbit, R2. Now the difference between these two will be the energy required, because energy required. Is equal to E2 minus E1. Here you can write here minus 1 by 2. R2 is double R1. So E2 value. Minus E1 value so delta E is equal to so what can be taken common 1 by 2 G M by R1 so 1 minus here we have 1 by 2 so we get 1 by 2 1 by 2 into 1 by 2 1 by 4 R1. Let us substitute the values 1 by 4 into 24 R1 means RE plus H. See. Earth radius is 6400 kilometers. H value is sorry here minus earth radius height R1s here R1 value is given sorry. You have to write this as 1 by 4 G capital M E small m by R1 means 2 RE 2 into RE value 6400 kilometers into 10 power 3 meters that value here comes here two into 10 power 3 substituting the values we get three point 13 into 10 power 9 joules Now, next question is, what are the changes in kinetic energy? See, kinetic energy, or K1, let me write. K1 is equal to 1 by 2 G, M by R1 K2 is equal to 1 by 2 G capital M by R2 Now change in kinetic energy that is equal to see here R2 means double R1 so what can be taken common? 1 by 2 g m e m by r1 can be taken common. So here what remains? 1 by 2 remains, and here 1. So we get here minus 1 by 2 into 1 by 2 minus 1 by 4. R. So here already we got the same value we got here. Therefore, we get the same value. This is second answer. But you see the difference. Here, here delta is positive. What does it suggest? This much energy must be supplied to the satellite orbiting in the lower orbit to get into the higher orbit. This much energy must be supplied from outside. This much energy must be given to the system from outside. That is why this is positive. But here you see the change in kinetic energy is negative. What does this suggest? This suggests that the kinetic energy, when the satellite moved from lower orbit to higher orbit, its kinetic energy decreased. This minus sign tells you that when satellite moved from lower orbit to higher orbit, its kinetic energy decreased. Kinetic energy is decreased. Now, if kinetic energy is decreased, potential energy must be increased. Okay. Now let us find change in potential energy. U1 is equal to minus G Earth mass, satellite mass by R1. U2, Earth mass, satellite mass by R2. Double R1. Now, change in potential energy. GMEMR1 taken common, 1 by 2 plus 1 minus 1 by 2, 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 or 1. See, this plus sign tells you what? Increase in potential energy. Here kinetic energy decreased, here potential energy increased. Here for 1 by 4 GMEM by R1 we got this much value. and here we have 1 by 2, that means double this value. So here multiplying this by 2, we get for 1 by 2. Therefore we multiply this by 2 value here, 2 into 3.13 10 power 9. This is another answer. What is a geostationary satellite? State its uses. If the period of revolution of an artificial satellite is equal to the period of rotation of Earth, and the satellite moves around Earth in the direction of Earth rotation, then the satellite would appear stationary viewed from a point on Earth. Hence, such satellites are called geostationary satellites. To understand this, we can make an activity. Suppose this is Earth made of thermocol, suppose, and this is a satellite. So with a spoke you connect these two. Now taking some support, you move this horizontally. As the satellite completes one revolution, Earth completes one rotation. And for a person who is sitting here, who is standing here, this appears stationary. He is just above his head, overhead. Even though it is moving around Earth, it doesn't seem moving. The reason is the speed of revolution of satellite and speed of rotation of Earth, both are same. You can tell in terms of speed or in terms of time. Suppose our Earth takes 24 hours to complete one rotation. So by the time it completes one rotation, the satellite completes one revolution. That is, its period of revolution also 24 hours. So in this way, both have same time periods. For us, this satellite appears stationary. That's why this satellite is called geostationary satellite. So this is our Earth, this is North Pole, this is South Pole, and this is a line joining the poles, and this is axis of rotation. So around this axis, our Earth is rotating. And around Earth, satellite is moving. Here one more important thing is, if our Earth is, here you see, if our Earth is moving clockwise, satellite also should move clockwise in the same direction, then only it can appear stationary. If one is moving clockwise, another is moving anti-clockwise, we cannot find it stationary. So that is why here you see the arrow marks. See, our Earth rotation is shown clockwise, in the clockwise direction. It is moving. See, our earth moves from west to east. That's why sun rises in the east and sets in the west. Okay, so our earth moves from west to east. So in this way its rotation is shown, and in the same direction our satellite also moving with same time period, with same time period. Now you know the expression for time period. Time is equal to distance traveled. Time is equal to distance by speed. So here distance covered by the satellite is 2 pi r, where r is the radius of the orbit, and v naught is the orbital speed. Now r is nothing but earth radius, sum of earth radius and height on height of the satellite from surface earth. Okay, here orbital speed, that also substituted. So this is expression for time period, time taken for the satellite to complete one revolution. But this is time taken for one revolution of satellite is made equal to time of rotation of earth, and which is 24 hours. So if this must be equal to 24 hours, see in this expression, let us see. Pi is a constant, r is a constant, earth radius, capital G constant, mass of earth is constant. So which is a variable? H is a variable, because you can choose at what height the satellite should revolve around earth. This we can choose. So this height is so chosen that it takes 24 hours of time to complete one revolution. So the H value is chosen, and that value is, if you take in place of H this much value, then only you get T is equal to 24 hours. So the height is the height that must be chosen to have this much time period is 35,800 kilometers. Now let us consider its uses of geostationary satellite. It is used to study the upper layers of the atmosphere. It is used to forecast the changes in the atmosphere. We can avoid loss caused by cyclones. It alarms us about the changes in atmosphere. Third one, know the shape and size of the earth. Fourth one, identify the minerals and natural resources present inside and on the surface of earth. So such satellites are called remote sensing satellites also. Here these satellites see the areas of forests, deserts on the land, and also areas on the ocean, and take pictures. With these pictures, proper steps are taken to prevent deforestation and expansion of deserts. Collection of large number of fish in certain area of an ocean can be detected by a satellite. This would enable fishermen to catch the fish. Presence of minerals, ores, and groundwater in a region of the land, in a country, could be detected from the pictures sent by satellites. And such satellites are called remote sensing satellites. Now, next, fifth one, transmit the TV programs to distant places. Satellites help develop to reliable communication links between different countries separated by large distances on the globe. The communications include telephone conversations, fax messages, and contact through internet. Such satellites are called communication satellites. Next, sixth one. Study the properties of radio waves in the upper layers of the atmosphere. Seventh one. Undertake space research, that is to know about the planets, satellites, and comets, etc. And satellites have also been used for spying by defense services of country. What is a polar satellite? State its uses. A polar satellite is a low altitude satellite which goes around poles of the earth in a north-south direction. So it is observe the definitions of geostationary satellite and polar satellites. By comparing, we get a good understanding. Polar satellite is a low altitude. The height from the surface of Earth is very low, and it goes around poles of the Earth in a north-south direction. You look at the direction here. See, the polar satellites move around Earth vertically like this. It moves around Earth vertically like this, around poles. See, whereas if you look at the geostationary satellite, the geostationary satellite moves around Earth in the equatorial plane. Around the equator it revolves. The satellite revolves around the equator, whereas a polar satellite moves over the poles and perpendicular to the equator. Another difference, you see, in case of geostationary satellite, to have time period of 24 hours, the height required was 35,800 kilometers. But here, in case of the polar satellite, the Earth is just 500 to 800 kilometers, low altitude. So here, the purpose of sending the polar satellite is different from that of geostationary satellite. Here, the time period also very much less. There, in case of geostationary satellite, the time period was 24 hours, and here it is just 100 minutes. It crosses any longitude many times a day. Camera in it can view only small strip of Earth in one orbit. Adjacent strips are viewed in next orbit. So we know that our Earth rotates on its axis. So its orbit is fixed, its vertical orbit is fixed, but Earth is moving from west to east on its own axis. So one latitude after another latitude, a strip is covered by the satellite. So when it comes again to this place, our Earth rotates, it moves by some distance, so the beside strip comes. In that way, it takes photos of the Earth strip-wise, one strip after another strip. Thus, entire Earth viewed strip by strip during the entire day. So, these satellites can view polar and equatorial regions at close distances with good resolution, because the distance is very much less, 500 to 800 kilometers. Therefore, it can take photos with good resolution. Now, second one, information gathered from such satellite is extremely useful for remote sensing and metrology. Metrology means weather science, and environmental studies. The last topic in this lesson we are left with is weightlessness. First, let us define what is weight. Weight of an object is the force with which the earth attracts it. We know very well the gravitational force working on a body is called its weight, and expression for weight is W is equal to mg. If a body is having mass m, on that the gravitational force working will be mg, and that is called its weight. Now let us look at these examples. Here one spring is attached to the support, one end is attached to the support, and the lower end is attached with a mass. And on this mass, now mg gravitational force will be working. Because of the gravitational force, the spring is stretched by some amount. And inside the spring, in the opposite direction, restoring force will be developed. Now, let us take another example. Here, a block is kept on the table surface. Its mass is W is equal to mg, and a normal reaction is same. It will also will be same. N is equal to mg. And a person is standing on a lift over a weight measuring scale. Suppose weight measuring scale. So here, the gravitational pull on him is mg, and N is the normal reaction, and this normal reaction is measured by the measuring device. Now, what happens to the tree under free fall? That should be considered here. Suppose you remove the spring from the support, from the fixed support. And just allow the spring mass system to fall freely. Then upper end of the spring and lower end that is mass, both will have same acceleration. Here A is equal to minus G, here also A is equal to minus G. Therefore, the spring is not stretched. Now, see here, if this is a spring balance, it will show zero reading. Similarly, here also, suppose you are standing on a weight reader and the lift is freely falling, suppose. Then the weight scale will show zero reading. Why means here both weight reader and yourself both are accelerated by the same value. Similarly, if you launch a satellite around Earth, see, each and every part of satellite will have same A is equal to minus G, same acceleration. They will have same acceleration due to gravity. Therefore, see here, in case of free fall, the upper part and lower part, the person and the weight reader, the table and the object, they are accelerated by the same amount. Therefore, here the weight scale shows zero reading. Here also the spring balance shows zero reading. It means weight becomes zero. That means here, if the lift is freely falling, see, you will not feel your weight. Here, because of the normal reaction, previously you felt some weight of your body, but when the lift is falling freely, you will not feel any weight of your body, and that is weightlessness. Similarly, the astronauts inside the satellite also feel the same thing. They feel the weightlessness because not only themselves but the each and every part of the satellite has same a value, that is they feel as if they are under free fall. So this is about the weightlessness.